Hey guys, welcome back to Warhol Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. This video, guys, we're making it because many of you asked us in the comment section below, guys, where to find the coolant temperature sensor and how to replace it on BMW Z4, guys. So that's what we'll be covering today. Now, we'll demonstrate on N52 engine. This is a 6-cylinder engine, but even if you have a Z4 with a newer engine, let's say 4-cylinder engine as well, we'll explain where you can find that sensor, where you can expect to find it, guys. We'll cover everything from start to finish today, guys. Now, quick introduction, guys. If you need to buy the replacement sensor, parts to use coolant, we'll share the links in the description of the video below. Another thing, every single car we get at the shop, we make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos, guys. Why we do all that? Simply because our mission at the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need, guys, in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video so we can keep providing that free information, guys, for you. Now, what is the correct way to change the coolant temperature sensor? Okay, before we start, guys, let me explain a few things. This is N52 engine. It has been used in Z4, 3 Series, 5 Series, BMW, X3 and X5. Super popular engine, guys. We'll demonstrate on that 3 Series because we wanted to make that video for any of you that asked where it's located and how to do it. On Z4, it's practically exactly the same, guys, location. The only difference, some models, but not all, will have a cooler right here, but your sensor that you need to remove is located over here, guys. This is your sensor on the cylinder here. This is the coolant temperature sensor. Now, before we start, guys, okay, let me explain a few things. Practically, you have to drain the cooling system to do that the correct way, but you can do it without it, and we'll show you what we do, but make sure you stand till the end because you have to finish one thing, otherwise you can severely damage your engine, guys. Now, if you do not drive the car for, let's say, overnight, 24 hours, your engine will be cold. That way you will not get burned by the coolant, but you will need to find on your Z4 the coolant radiator cap and slowly, guys, remove it so you can release the pressure out of the system. Perfect. Just like that. Then, this sensor, we need to disconnect the wire, guys. On the bottom, press in, pull it out. Let me show you what we have here now. Okay, this is the wire. Okay, right here. And now, with the wire being disconnected, we need to get a 22mm wrench and we need to go ahead, guys, okay, and remove the sensor. Now, make sure you stand till the end because we'll share another helpful tip that can be really painful to fix if you break it, and we'll explain what I'm talking about in just a second. Once it gets loose, grab your rubber glove, okay, and plug the hole in, guys. Okay, that way you will not leak too much of a coolant. Now, that sensor, when you get it tight, guys, you have to be extremely careful due to the fact that this sensor, guys, is super easy to break because it's hollow on the inside, so you don't want that to happen. Don't over tighten it. We'll try to put the torque specs in the description of the video below. Another thing, okay, right here, that washer, make sure it came with the sensor and it's not stuck on the cylinder yet. But other than that, okay, you can see, you get the idea. Now, let me show you guys what you need to do. You grab the new sensor when you are ready, okay, pull the finger out, and we go ahead, okay, and install the sensor. Always use gloves, guys. I should have got mine, I forgot, but never ever do what I do. Perfect. Get it tight, not too tight, but not to leak. Now install the wire, and two more things that we need to do. You have to make sure that you have enough coolant, okay, coolant in your radiator, guys. Make sure in your coolant tank it's full, where the, okay, for instance, okay, ours, you can see the floaty. Step number two, you have to bleed the cooling system. Now, there is a special procedure to follow. Otherwise, you can have an air pocket in your cylinder head that can result into overheating your engine. You don't want that to happen, guys. So, you need to bleed the cooling system. So, hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more help and see you guys next time.